In this lecture, we will try to introduce some of the applications of operational amplifier. The main or the fundamental use of operational amplifier is that it can be used as an inverting amplifier or non-inverting amplifier and a voltage follower. In this lecture, we will try to introduce this inverting and non-inverting operational amplifier, and in the coming lectures we will try to introduce the other applications like integration, differentiation, summing, subtraction, etc. using operational amplifier. So here we will discuss, first of all we will discuss about the inverting amplifier. An inverting amplifier is nothing but an ordinary amplifier with an output voltage has a phase difference of 180 degree with respect to the input voltage. That means there is a phase difference of 180 degree between the input and output voltages. So an inverting amplifier is an amplifier with a output voltage is out of phase with the input voltage. The circuit shown here represents a typical inverting amplifier. Here suppose we are using the IC741 as the operational amplifier, or any other ICs, the op amps are used, and the two terminals for the supply voltages will be there. That is plus V and minus V, and two input terminals. It is represented by negative and plus. The negative sign indicates that it is the inverting input terminal, and the plus represents the non-inverting input terminal, and there is an output terminal. Here you can see that we are discussing about the inverting amplifier. So the input voltage is applied to the inverting terminal of the op amp through a series resistance RI as shown here. The non-inverting terminal is grounded, so the voltage to the non-inverting terminal is zero here. And a resistance RF is used as the feedback resistor, which connects the output terminal to the inverting input terminal so that it provides a negative feedback. That means the output voltage and input are 180 degree out of phase. Since the input voltage is applied to the inverting terminal, so that inverted voltage is given back to the input terminal through a resistance represented by RF, which is called the feedback resistance. So the fraction of the output voltage fed back to the input signal will be 180 degree out of phase. So here we are using a negative feedback. So this circuit actually represents a negative feedback inverting amplifier. The input is applied to the inverting terminal of the op amp through a series resistance RI. Now let's see what will be the expression for the gain of an amplifier. For that, let's consider this input terminal. As you know that an op amp has a very high input impedance, so ideally no current flows to the input of the amplifier. That means if I1 is the current which is flowing to the input of this amplifier, which should be equal to 0 since the input impedance of the amplifier op amp is very high. So since the input impedance is very high, the voltage which appearing across this two input terminals should be zero. So we can say that whatever the voltage appearing here will be same as the voltage at this point A. So the voltage at the point B will be same as the voltage at the point A. Since the point B is grounded, then the voltage is equal to zero. So the point A will also have a voltage of V is equal to zero. That means the point A is called at a virtual ground. It is called virtual ground because the voltage at that node is equal to zero, but actually it is not connected to the ground. That's why it is called a virtual ground. So the node A is virtual grounded because of the voltage at the non-inverting terminal is zero, or it is actually grounded. So now, since there is no current flowing to this branch, that is towards the op amp or to the inside of the op amp, then whatever current is flowing through R1 will flow through the feedback resistance RF. So if you consider II is the current flowing through the resistance RI, and IF is the current flowing through the feedback resistance IF, that is II is the current through RI, and IF is the current through RF, the feedback resistance, then this should be, both should be equal, because there is no current. I1 is equal to zero. So since I1 is equal to zero, II should be equal to IF. But this II is the current flowing through RI, which is equal to voltage across RI divided by the resistance RI, which is equal to the voltage across RI is the voltage at the node A minus the input voltage divided by RI. Since the voltage node A is at virtual ground, the voltage at A is zero, so what we will have is minus V in divided by RI. Similarly, the current through the feedback resistance IF is given by the voltage across the feedback resistance RF divided by the resistance RF, which is equal to V out minus VA divided by RF, which is equal to V out divided by RF, since VA is equal to zero. Now we know that since I1 is equal to zero, that is current flowing to the op amp is zero, this current through the input resistance RI is same as the current through the feedback resistance RF. So we can, if we use this one, II is equal to IF, we will get minus V in divided by RI is equal to V out divided by RF. From this expression we will get V out divided by V in is equal to minus RF by RI. but V out by V in. V out is the output of the operational amplifier and V in is the input of the operational amplifier. The ratio of the output voltage to the input voltage is called the voltage gain. Here we are having a feedback resistance, so we can call it as closed loop gain, ACL, which is by definition it is V out by V in, which is given by minus Rf by Ri, where Rf is the feedback resistance. And Ri is the input resistance connected in the inverting terminal of the op-amp. So, according to this equation, the closed loop gain, the voltage gain of an operational amplifier is given by this equation. Here the negative sign indicates that the output voltage is out of phase with the input voltage. For our practical classes, we have to do this experiment where we will design a circuit with a particular Rf and Ri values. That is, we will design a circuit with a particular Rf and Ri values, and theoretically we will calculate the closed loop gain using the equation ACL is equal to minus Rf by Ri. Then we will note down the corresponding output and input voltages, and experimentally we will note down the V out and V in, the input and output voltage, and finding the values of ratio of these two, V out by V in. We will compare the theoretical and experimental values. That is the thing which we will do for our practical classes. Now, another application of the operational amplifier is the non-inverting amplifier. Non-inverting amplifier is an amplifier circuit which gives the output voltage, amplified output voltage, which is in phase with the input signal. That is, the phase difference between the input signal and amplified output voltage will be 0 degree or 360 degree. That is, there is no phase difference between the input voltage and the amplified output voltage. The non-inverting amplifier using an operational amplifier circuit is shown here. Here you can see that the voltage V in is connected to the non-inverting input terminal of the operational amplifier, and there is an input resistance Ri which is connected to the inverting terminal of the amplifier, and the other end is grounded. And a feedback resistance Rf is connected from the output terminal to the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. So Ri is the input resistance and Rf is the feedback resistance here used here, and Vin is the voltage applied here. Since the operational amplifier has a very high input impedance, the voltage drop, there is no current flowing into the operational amplifier, so that the voltage drop across the two terminal, input terminals, that is inverting and non-inverting terminals, can be taken to be zero. Then the voltage across the non-inverting terminal will be same as the voltage at the inverting terminal. So here Vin is the applied voltage, then the same voltage will appear at the NOT gate of the circuit. So if we consider the circuit of a non-inverting amplifier, it consisting of an operational amplifier with a signal is applied to the non-inverting terminal, and two resistances RI and RF are connected to the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. They forms the input resistance and the feedback resistances respectively. That means RF is connected across the output terminal and the inverting input terminal of the op amp, and RI, the input resistance, is connected to the inverting input terminal, and the other end of the RI is grounded. So this is the circuit of a non-inverting operational amplifier. Now, to calculate the gain of this non-inverting amplifier, let's consider the current flowing through the two resistances RI and RF, the current through the input resistance and current through the feedback resistance. We know that since the input impedance is very high, the current that actually flowing into the circuit, which we have taken I1 in the previous discussion, is zero. So this IRI will be equal to IRF. The current through the input resistance should be equal to the current through the feedback resistance. Now, if we consider the current through the input resistance, which is equal to actually the voltage across RI divided by RI, which is equal to the voltage across RI is the voltage at the two terminals of RI. The two terminals of RI, one is at A and other is at this point. So at A the voltage is V in, the other end is grounded, so it is V in minus 0 divided by RI, so which is V in by RI. And the current through the feedback resistance is given by voltage across RF divided by the resistance RF. The voltage across RF is the voltage across the two terminals of RF. The this terminal the voltage is V out, and at this terminal the voltage is V in. So it is V out minus V in divided by RF. Now these two expressions are equal, then we can write it as V in divided by RI is equal to V out minus V in divided by RF, which is equal to, if we take V in by RF to the LHS, we will get V in into 1 by RI plus 1 by RF is equal to V out divided by RF. So from this equation, if we take the ratio V out by V in, which is equal to RF into 1 by RI plus 1 by RF, which is equal to RF into, if we cross multiply these two and take the LCM, we will get RI plus RF divided by RI into RF. This RF and RF will cancel. So what remains is RI divide plus RF divided by RI, which can be written as RI by RI is 1 plus RF by RI. So the voltage ratio of the output voltage to the input voltage is called the closed loop gain LCL for a non-inverting amplifier is given by 1 plus RF by RI. So this is the expression for the gain of a non-inverting amplifier. The previous case, that is for inverting amplifier, we have seen that the closed loop gain is minus RF by RI. So this here it is 1 plus RF by RI. That means for inverting amplifier, if closed loop gain is 150, then same circuit, for the same circuit, if we make it as a non-inverting amplifier just by connecting the signal or the input voltage source to the non-inverting terminal, the closed loop gain will become 150 plus 1, that is 151. Now another interesting thing is that if you make this RF a 0, that is practically if you consider a non-inverting amplifier with an input resistance RI and an input voltage source Vin, gives some output voltage V out through a feedback resistance RF, then for this circuit the gain is SEL is equal to V out by V in, which is equal to 1 plus RF by RI. Now if we make this RF a 0, that is if RF is equal to 0, that is the closed loop gain will be V out by V in, which is equal to 1 plus 0 by RI, which is equal to 1. That is V out by V in is equal to 1, which implies V out is equal to V in. The output voltage is same as the input voltage, which is called a voltage follower. So in order to make this circuit as a voltage follower, we have to remove this RF, and removing the RF means just short it. Here RF is equal to 0. So this is the circuit of a voltage follower. Voltage follower means the output follows the input. The output voltage will be same as the input voltage. So you know, we can make a voltage follower from a non-inverting amplifier just by putting a wire or short across the feedback resistance. That's all about the inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier and the voltage follower. Thank you.